making their festival debut this year is the Lady Luck Trio. They met at Utah State, and if you remember a few years ago, Utah State brought a whole production here, so they were in that production. They're presenting two different programs. Will appear tomorrow morning at our big band breakfast, and then tomorrow afternoon they will present the 1940s Radio Gold. This afternoon their show is Great American Ladies of Song. So that's all I need to tell you. All you have to do is sit back and enjoy. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the Lady Luck Trio.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Lady Luck, featuring their exciting tribute to great ladies of American song.
She took it, my little yellow bag. wanted to cover her music. The greats like Ava Cassidy, Diana Krall, even Doris Day, they covered her music. Like this one, Dream a Little Dream of Me. Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me.
He's reveling, he
puts the boys to sleep with boogie every night, and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet, cause ain't no one knows and someone gives them a beat. Oh, oh, he wakes them up when he plays for a boogie. He's a boogie boogie bugle boy from the EB. A whoop, a choo, a choo, a choo, a choo, a choo. He goes in eight to the bar. He can't blow a note unless the bass guitar is with him. Oh, wham, bam. And the company jumps when he plays Reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy from the EB.
You Baby! presented to several people in the 50s, but it never really caught on until a young Leanne Rimes took it and made it her own. This is Blue.
Love.
preview of what's going to happen tomorrow with our 1940s radio review. My name's Derek Furch, and I was the director of the program at Utah State 20 years ago that we brought out. We actually brought out three different programs, two big ones with a big band and another one we sang along with a big band that was here. And all of these students, these were all from my batch of students way back then, and now we still have a chance to get together and put some of these shows together. So it's such a treat working with them. But I just want to tell you how much I admire and love people here in Clarinda, starting right with Marv and Jean Negley, the people that have been organizing and associated with this festival ever since its inception, I believe. They are such wonderful, humble, warm people, and those of you that have had a chance to meet them know what I'm talking about, you fellow Clarindians or whatever you call yourselves, but we just are so impressed with the wonderful feelings that we have here in Clarinda. It's a real treat. I wanted to tell you while they're changing, one of the last shows we did, and I believe it was in the year 2000, it was in the Leeds Center. Just out of curiosity, how many of you have been coming here for many, many years? Oh, look at that, lots of hands. Okay, good, good. How many of you think you were here maybe 20 years ago? Remember the group from Utah State University, a few of you? Good, good. Kind of a funny thing that happened there. We were doing one of our big productions, and Norm Layden was here then too, and he had just done something with his clarinet in there. It was kind of a neat workshop. And then afterwards, the clouds were starting to kind of roll in, and there was a little bit of interesting stuff happening up in the sky. And I remember joking a little bit about it. Look at those clouds, they kind of look like pillows up there. And the people from Clarinda here that I was joking with didn't laugh. They said, they kind of have a greenish color, and they still didn't laugh. Well, anyway, we got into the show, and we were in the middle of running the show, and we had probably a 40-foot-wide stage, a temporary stage that we brought in. It was up about 4 feet off the ground, all on scaffolding, you know, all these risers. We had our big band up there, and the singers and dancers out in front, and I was standing outside by the brick wall, the doorway that goes into the Leeds Center there. And the fire marshal was standing there with me. And the clouds were getting worse and worse. And I think they had already announced some kind of a watch. Before the warning, they have a watch or something like that for tornadoes. And he nudged me a little bit. We've been talking, so I knew he was a pleasant, funny guy, okay? But he nudged me a little bit. He said, "How many of these people do you think we could fit underneath your risers?" And I thought, well, finally, somebody's making a joke. And I laughed, and he said, "I'm not kidding." And I remember trying to picture this crowd of people crawling under these risers, and thank goodness that didn't happen, because I know that could be a real serious thing. But anyway, lots and lots of good memories, and we just thank so much to the people around here. Tomorrow, what we're going to do is shift gears a little bit. We're also going to bring in a guest to sing with Lady Luck. His name is Ken Handy. He'll be a part of the program as well. We're going to take you back in time to the 1940s. Wonderful music, wonderful events. America pulled together in a way that we've probably never known since. And so much of it was through music by the great big band artists, and especially Glenn Miller himself. What an icon, what an idol, what a tremendous man, and what a huge ball he started rolling of all of this wonderful, powerful, meaningful music. But anyway, we're going to pretend like we're at a live radio broadcast now and give you just a few minutes of this. So I'm going to turn the time over to our local DJ here as we take you into the radio show, Mr. Ken Handy. Give Mr. Ken Handy a big hand.
So I don't even have to say anything and you clap for me. That's great. Well, I'm no lady, but I think I'm lucky, so hopefully I can blend in with these girls. So. Okay, we're live in the set in 3, 2, 1. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Lady Luck's 1940s Radio Gold. You're listening to America's favorite broadcast hour, featuring the golden oldies from the days of Radio Gold. WKRG is proud to be bringing you the very best of American big band legacy. So you kids out there, hang on to your dancing shoes, because we've got a lot more coming your way. But before we go any further, a word from one of our fine sponsors, Chiquita Bananas.
Yeah.
folks in our studio audience, and thank you, Chiquita Bananas. We certainly hope you found that appealing. Now, for all you guys and gals that are just waiting in your wingtips, what better music for cutting a rug than that of Glenn Miller and his orchestra? Here's a medley featuring some of your favorites, and we're going to throw in a couple from his friends, Benny Goodman and Count Basie as well. So grab your partner and let the jumping begin.
Or you can give me a shot.
Can you afford?